Hello and welcome to Duska Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, we are going to understand about Tesca's automatic motor starter panel. So this is a three-phase starter panel. Through this panel, we will control an induction motor of three-phase with the manual mode and as well as in auto mode. So this is our automatic starter panel. The order code for this starter panel is 19204149.144. So this is the order code and this is the starter panel. In this starter panel, there are the three RYB indications. When the power supply is connected, three phase power supply, the indications will be glowing and showing that the power is connected. This is the anode terminal for the contactor, and the contactor is already installed inside this panel. And this is the thermal relay, and this is the start and stop button of this to start and stop the motor. So this is the basically a DOL in the manual mode which will be used, and this is the manual and auto toggle switch to control the different modes. This is the manual mode, this is the auto mode. This is the input terminal for three-phase supply. The three-phase supply will be provided here at this, and this is the motor terminals. So the output from this panel will be provided to the motor from these terminals. Now this is the automatic controlling section, for which we have installed here the basic timer to time programming the timing with the program time. We will control the motor automatically starting and stopping. These are the start and reset button to reset the timer and to start the timer, and we will also program this timer as per our requirements. These are the NO terminals of this timer and these are the NC terminal of this timer. So we will perform the connections. So this is a three-phase induction motor which we are using to control from this panel, and this is the three-phase power supply board. So from this panel we will connect the three-phase power supply. Before working on the three-phase power supply, always make sure that you have taken the proper safety measurements, and according to the manual, for all the safety measures and all the procedure are given in this manual. So we will follow the procedure. For this we will connect the RYB and neutral to this panel of the input supply. For this we will connect R to R, Y to Y, and blue to blue, and also we require a black neutral cable. So these three R will be connected to the input terminals like this, and the neutral will also be connected to the neutral point. So neutral is necessary to control the contactor. Now we will connect the supply to motor. For this we will require RYB patch codes as well. So R will be connected to R, B will be B, and Y will be at the Y terminal. Now we will connect this terminal to the motor section. So this is the B and Y. So motor connections has been done. Now first we will connect this and do the experiment in the manual board. For this, change this selector switch to manual mode like this, and now we power on the supply of three phase. Now you can see the three RYB indicators are now glowing. So this is the three phase power supply is on, and the thermal overload relay will be connected. So as I on this start button, the motor starts running. So I press the start button and you can see motor has been started running here. So this is the manual operation. For this, now to stop the motor, I will press the stop button from here. So as I press the stop button, motor has been stopped. You can see. Now we will do the manual operation. With the automatic controlling of this motor. For this, we will turn this switch to auto mode, and now we require two patch codes to connect the NO terminal of the timer to the NO terminal of the contactor. Before this, turn off the three-phase supply. for the safety purpose. Now we have turned off the supply connecting. Now we will again turn on the supply, and now we will set the timer as our requirement to control the motor. For this we will set the seconds, so I will set it to 10 seconds. Now you can see the timer has been set to 10 seconds. Now as I press the start button, timer starts running and motor also starts and running for 10 seconds and it will automatically stops after 10 seconds. So as I press start, sorry, the reset, sorry, after, you can see right now the green LED is blinking here. So that as I enter the timer, after entering the timer, press set button and you can see the timer has been started and motor on for 10 seconds. After 10 seconds motor will automatically stops. So the 10 seconds has been completed and motor goes stop. So you can increase and decrease the timer in the seconds, minutes as you want. You can go through the timer's manual for references. Now as I increase the value of time to 15 seconds and set this, and now we will, after completing cycle, we have to start again and reset the timer. So resetting the timer will give the timer restarting the timer, and the motor will be only on for the 15 seconds and it will stop after 15 seconds completed. So motor has been stopped. Now for this, if you want to control the same in the on delay timing, as at this time the motor is running because the timer has been completed. So as I reset the timer and start the timer from 15 seconds again, the motor will get a on delay and it will do the on delay function. So after 15 seconds now the motor will start when the 15 seconds completed. So this is the basic reverse function from the NC terminals. Now as the timer completed, the motor will start running and it will be running till we control and off the supply. So after resetting, the motor will again get the time delay and start. So these are the different programming methods there are in the timer. You can control the motor for the different timing methods. So that's how we use the automatic starter panel. The motor panel can be used up to 7.5 kilowatt. This motor panel can be used up to 7.5 kilowatts for 415 volts motor. So more than 7.5 kilowatt motor should not be used with this panel, because the panel has not that much capacity to operate. So now that's how we use the panel for while performing this panel. If you find any difficulties with the experiment, you can easily contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the support. Thank you.